Do you help your neighbors carry their burdens? My dear brothers and sisters, today's first reading is taken from Romans chapter 2, verses 2 to 11. St. Paul tells us in the first reading that God will reward all those who have been good and keep to His ways. Those who refuse to repent and continue in their sinful ways will always receive their reward, but each person's reward depends on what they have done in life in terms of faith and helping their fellow men and women. Paul makes sure that he implicates the self-righteous person in these verses. We can sense how he traps the Jews in the way that they condemn the pagans and their ways. They would say, "We are above judgment because we can so clearly see the sins of those people." But Paul responds, "You verify you are liable to the same judgment, if not a worse one, because you do know the law and practice the same things as pagans." This perfectly pictures the error of the self-righteousness. A self-righteous person is the one who considers himself righteous in his own eyes rather than through God's eyes. And again in the Gospel, Luke 11 verses 42 to 46, Jesus also has the same point to drive home to teachers of the law and lawyers. Why does Jesus single out the religious teachers and lawyers for some rather strong words of rebuke? The word "woe" can also be translated as "alas." It is as much an expression of sorrowful pity as it is of anger. Why did Jesus lament and issue such a stern rebuke? Jesus was angry with the religious leaders because they failed to listen to God's word and they misled the people they were supposed to guide in the ways of God. God's commandments are rooted in His love and care of us. The scribes devoted their lives to the study of the law of Moses and regarded themselves as legal experts in it. But they were so exacting in their interpretations and in trying to live them out that they had little time for anything else. In their misguided zeal, they required unnecessary and burdensome rules which obscured the more important matters of religion, such as love of God and the love of neighbor. They were leading people to Pharisaism rather than to God. They are very attentive to minute matters of little importance, but they neglected to care for the needy and the weak. Jesus admonished them because their hearts were not right. They were filled with pride and contempt for others. They put unnecessary burdens on others while neglecting to show charity, especially to the weak and the poor. Love lifts the burdens of others. What was the point of Jesus' lesson? The essence of God's commandments is love. Love of the supreme good, God Himself, and love of our neighbor who is made in the image and likeness of God. God is love, 1 John chapter 4 verse 8, and everything He does flows from His love for us. God's love is unconditional and is wholly directed towards the good of others. True love both embraces and lifts the burdens of others. Paul reminds us that God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit, which has been given us. Romans chapter 5 verse 5. Do you help your neighbors carry their burdens? God gives each of us sufficient grace for each day to love as He loves and to lift the burdens of others as they too may experience the grace and love of Christ. Lord Jesus, inflame my heart with Your love that I may always pursue what matters most, love of You and love of my fellow neighbor whom You have made in Your own image and likeness. Free my heart from selfish desires that I may only have room for kindness, mercy, goodness towards every person I know and meet. Amen.